Once Upon a Time in the Projects.
Down a cardboard condo, homeboy in a homemade bungalow, in the middle of the end of the dead in one way
Oh, yes, coffee's ready, too. I'm sorry, we're out of Sunny D. Chitlins? Why would you want chitlins for breakfast?
I was clearing my throat. We got chitlins?
There's chitlins for husbands who do their morning power walks.
Sure, on the outside, it looks like I have it all going on. But inside, I'm empty. Last night, I even tried to take my own...
Hold that innermost thought. That's Calvin and Juicy. What are those boys doing out of school?
Playing hooky.
No, not Calvin. He knows better.
Maybe he's following Juicy.
Calvin is not a follower. He's a leader.
You're right. He's leading Juicy straight into that R-rated movie.
What the... Get... No. Let's get him. Oh, sorry.
Watch
pardon.
Sorry.
Watch you. Hey, I don't know you.
Better be sorry.
Get off me. Ooh, that tickle. All right, look. Now we gotta be as inconspicuous as possible. We want them to know we're here.
Okay, Thurgood.
Shh! You got no volume control on that thing?
I have reverb.
Quiet down. I think I see him.
Aha! You're a crackhead!
Unhand me, you fiend! Usher?
Calvin, get back here!
I'm sorry, sir, but yelling is not allowed, unless it's at the screen.
Oh, sorry. Don't take him back, girl. Yeah, leave him alone, baby. There, you happy? Sanchez, when I get a hold of that boy, I'll teach him not to ditch his responsibilities, even if I have to skip work every day for a week. Oh, now, we all know the importance of school. I mean, when I was a boy, I went to school every day. The summers, too.
You even did some grades twice.
That's right. But I was a special student. Anyway, we're here to talk about Calvin. Now to break down the criminal mind for us, Mr. Walter Burkett. Walter?
Well, in my capacity as a parole officer, I don't deal with young children. I work mainly with their teenage parents.
But what we need to know is this. If he skips again tomorrow, where is he most likely to go?
Well, he ain't going to Harvard, that's for sure.
I'll tell you where he's gonna wind up. Kicking back with his homies, drinking 40s.
What an ugly future. We can't let that happen. So we need a plan. And another round. Another round? Shh, here they come.
Juicy, your sign's on backwards.
Oh, how humiliating.
Look at him making their plans. Hi, boys.
Hi, Super.
Hi, Jimmy. Hi, boys.
What's that guy's name with the funny voice?
Oh, no. My mom said not to stare at him.
Hi.
Look at him. Trying to hide. Guilty. All right, listen. We're going to use these chess pieces to go over our strategy. We're going to stake out the whole movie theater. I'll be here. Jimmy's over here. Sanchez, you're here.
I can't be there because then I can only move diagonally.
We ain't playing chess. And you, what's up with that getup? I told you to wear something inconspicuous so you don't get noticed.
I won't be. How you like me now?
All right, here's Walter with the equipment.
I got everything here for a proper takedown. Rifles, shotguns, night vision, binoculars, tasers.
Hey, Walter. All we need is walkie-talkies.
I knew I forgot something. We'll swing by Toys R Us.
All right, let's go. Ready?
Ready?
Testing. Can anyone hear me? Repeat, can anyone hear me? I can't talk through these damn machines.
Welcome to my hell.
Get back on the roof. Jimmy, come here.
Come in, Jimmy. Are you there? Jimmy!
Help! My baby's choking, and
Would you get off this channel? It's for emergencies only.
This is Jimmy.
Finally! Did you give me some red hots?
They ain't got no red hots.
All right, then, give me nachos. And dig deep into the cheese sauce. The top's just oil. Repeat, the top's just oil.
All right, here they come now. Uh-oh. They're walking by the theater. Whitney Houston, we have a problem. They're not taking the bait.
Don't worry, I'll get them. They don't know me. I'm a complete stranger. Hey, boys! I got some free movie tickets and candy. Who wants some?
Run!
What kind of candy?
Juicy, run!
Oh, you bad!
I'll get him. That is not a good pain.
We'll never catch him on foot. Jump in.
Now, where do you think you boys are going?
To school.
I know you played hooky yesterday, Calvin. I saw you at the movies.
At the movies? That must have been some other kid.
And his fat friend.
But I could have sworn that was you I seen. Man, how could I make a mistake like that?
I think he's buying it. Well, while you think about it, Super, we're gonna go to school. Like we do every day.
Hey, Juicy, you left your sign at the movies yesterday.
Nice try, Super. But I know for a fact that I didn't have my sign with me at the movies yesterday. Uh-oh.
Aha!
Juicy!
He made me do it!
Calvin, Calvin, Calvin. Skipping school, Calvin. I thought you had much more ambition than that. I got a good mind to tan your hide.
I'll skip school, too.
That's nice, boy. Run along now. Now you. A little hard work will teach you to ditch your responsibilities. You see this wall of graffiti? You're gonna paint the whole thing.
Oh, man. It's Saturday.
And when you get done with that wall, you're gonna start on this wall.
But that's our school project.
No buts. Just paint.
Can I go now?
Well, let's see how you did first. Oh, ain't it a shame it all bled through. I guess it'll need another coat tomorrow at 7 a.m.
But I have church!
This is more important. It'll make you a better person.
Hello, Thurgood. How did the big punishment go?
Great. Went fantastic. You know, you gotta teach the babies, Muriel. Each one, teach one. That's what I always say.
Oh, I'm so proud of you, Goody. You know what? I'm gonna put your heart smart meal right back in the cellar bag and chicken fry you a steak.
Ow! All right, now, don't be stingy with the bacon grease.
Do you think Calvin learned his lesson about skipping school?
Well, if he hasn't, he will by the end of tomorrow, that's for sure.
Another day of punishment? Thurgood, don't you think you're overdoing it a bit?
Muriel, I am the superintendent of this building, and if I have the authority to marry people, then I certainly have the authority to discipline a boy.
You don't have the power to marry people?
I don't. Let's not tell the Hudsons in fold, too, please. Come on, boy, work it, work it!
It's no use, Super. I can't do it.
That's because you gave up.
I didn't give up. The wrench doesn't fit.
Well, if it doesn't fit, you must have quit. That's what Mr. Janice say. You see, boy, you gotta communicate with the faucet. Let the faucet know who's boss. Here, give me the wrench. Let me show you. Watch this. There. Yeah, I thought not.
Let me try that. There. Up at the top.
Baby steps, Calvin. Baby steps. That was cute, though. Won't stop running, huh? You didn't put anything down it, did you?
No. A goat's head wrapped in paper towels.
No paper towels! How many times do I have to tell you people that?
Maybe I should cast a spell. I know. I'll sacrifice a rooster.
Now, let's see. Your toilet stopped. You could sacrifice a rooster, or you could jiggle the handle. There.
You the man, Super.
You see, Calvin, just as a good student wins the respect of a teacher, a good Super wins the respect of a toilet.
Uh-oh.
Oh, my God. Run for your life. My God, it's an F3. Calvin, quickly, take Hayden later to safety.
Oh, my poor quarry.
I'm going in. If I don't make it, tell Muriel I died with my dignity.
Wow, Super, that F3 was amazing. You ever seen anything bigger, like an F4 or an F5?
F5? Nobody's ever lived through an F5. That's the stuff of legends. Like Paul Bunyan or the moon landing.
This is the most exciting job on Earth. Man, I want to be a super just like you.
Well, get in line, boy.
Did you find the problem yet, son?
There's something stuck in here.
Well, pull it out.
Some kind of tool belt.
Oh, and it's a nice one, too. Any aspiring super would be proud to have that tool belt. Does it say who it belongs to on it?
Someone named Clavin.
Clavin? Yeah, before A except after C. Damn. Look, give me that. Now, you're a real super.
Look around you, son. One day this will all be yours, except for the dark place over there. Don't go there.
Here's your dinner. I know how hungry you get after a hard day's butting in.
Thank you. It's nice to be appreciated. Thurgood here. Well, let me ask you a question. Who the hell are you to tell me what's best for Calvin? Oh, his parents. Good answer. Uh-huh. Right. No more punishing.
I'll tell him he can't be a super.
Got it. Well, thank you for calling. All right, bye-bye.
Well, what did they say?
Well, they want me to fix a few things. The toilet and the radiator and a terrible situation I caused with the boy. As you all have heard, I overstepped my bounds with young Calvin. Evidently, his parents don't want him hanging around with Mr. Super all the time.
Why don't you just pack up and leave?
Now, it's not going to be that easy. Because the problem now is that the boy wants to be a super. So what we're going to have to do is deglamorize my job. You know, show him the ugly side. You people. I'm going to bring him in, and what I want you all to do is pretend that being a super is a really, really crummy job.
It is.
Yeah, that's good. Just like that. That's the right attitude. But save it for the boy. Okay, I'll go get him. And by the way, I'd like to thank you all in advance. Calvin, some of the tenants here have a few suggestions. And it's part of the job as a super to lend a friendly ear. Who would like to begin? Is there anyone that would like to begin?
My apartment's too hot. It's lost its old people smell.
Oh, that's a very serious complaint, Mrs. Avery. Thank you. You see what I mean, boy? That's the kind of stuff I deal with on a daily basis. Is there anyone else?
I think the roster man has a question.
When are you gonna fix the smoke alarm in my apartment?
I thought it was working.
Exactly.
You see, Calvin, it just goes on and on. You don't want to be around this.
Your job is lord in the belly of a snake.
Huh. Whoa. See, Calvin, something like that could really hurt my feelings if I didn't have such thick skin.
We'd be better off with a snake for a super.
Yeah, at least they could get rid of the rats.
Okay.
I fail to see how this is helping the boy.
Let me just cut to the chase. Your job stinks, and you stink in it.
Dang! Super? I don't think I want to be a super anymore.
Yeah, neither do I.
Mrs. Banks, I'm so glad Calvin changed his mind. Well, don't thank me. It was Thurgood's idea. Would you like to talk to him personally? He's right here. Hello? Hello? She must have gone through a tunnel.
Look, don't try to spare my feelings, Muriel. I'm a bad super and everybody knows it.
I know the tenants have chipped away at your self-esteem and you're feeling resentful and melancholy. Mad and sad.
Yeah, sad. And mad.
You want to play your cheer-up song?
Maybe that'll help.
I got something that makes me want to shout. I got something that tells me what it's all about.
I got soul, and I'm super bad.
Bad super. I mean, super bad.
That's it. Get on the goody foot. Now you go out there, face those tenants, and show them that you're the hardest working man in the projects.
Hey, watch me. I got it. Look, listen here.
I got soul, and I'm super bad.
It's okay, Thurgood. You can fix the hi-fi.
I already did.
Super, when you gonna fix my heat?
Fix it this morning.
What about my leaky ceiling?
Patched it.
The roof?
Patched it.
What about my toilet?
Been there. Plunge that.
Look, I baked you a nice Prozac pumpkin pie. Don't you want two slices every 4 hours? Come in.
Hi, Mrs. Stubbs. Hi, Super.
Hello.
Oh, hello, Calvin. Very good. Your friend Calvin is here. Want to go out and play?
I just want to talk to him.
All right. I'll leave you boys alone. Try to get him to eat 100 milligrams of pie.
Hey, you ain't sad because I don't want to be a super, are you?
I take comfort in knowing that one of us made the right choice.
I know those people said some hurtful things, but they didn't mean it. I mean, people never mean what they say.
You really mean that? Oh, who am I kidding? I'm the worst janitor ever. I mean, I don't even deserve to have my hands in a toilet.
Of course you do, Super. Your whole life is in the toilet.
Yeah, maybe once in the halcyon days of last week.
Halcyon? Is he eating his pie?
Calvin, I have been stripped of my dignity. Now, will you please just let me watch Judge Judy in peace?
Why don't you get a job?
Yeah, you loser.
I'll get him out of that chair. Now, which antenna is Super's? I just have to take out all of them.
Oh, man, this lousy reception. There. Perfect. Nobody move. Oh, looks like that frog channel finally ran out of money. Hey, wait a minute. It's all the channels. When are they going to perfect antenna technology?
Oh, God. Calvin's in trouble. I better get help.
Juicy Hudson supper.
Coming.
Now I'm going to miss my back-to-back Monday shows. What the hell, hell, Cool J? Holy Moesha. Calvin, what are you doing down there?
Hanging.
Don't worry. I'm going to pull you up.
No, Super, don't touch it.
All right, look. I'll pull you in through the window. Hey, the lady, open up. Open up. Grab my arm.
It's too short.
Okay, then grab my hair.
That's okay. Hey, why don't I try to swing over to that duct?
No, don't do that. It's only attached with duct tape.
The drain pipe.
Garbage twisters.
Well, I could grab onto that ledge.
No, it ain't up to code.
Fire escape?
Not if you want to live.
Is there anything in a stupid building you did fix?
Yes, I fixed the toilet, smart mouth. I saved your screaming butt from the F3, remember?
Yeah, it just flashed before my eyes a minute ago.
Wait a second. The F3. That's it, the F3.
What's it?
Hang on, Calvin. I'm going to save you yet. Got to figure out a way to clog up this toilet. But how? How? Come on, Thurgood, think. Think like a tenant. Oh!
Yep.
Look. Get back. Look!
Super! I'm gonna die! And I'm getting a wedgie!
Don't worry. Just clinch! There. Okay. Watch out now! She's getting ready to blow! Wait a minute. What's wrong? What didn't I do? ingredient. Hell, berry, full of grapes.
Super! What's happening?
There's nothing to worry about. I just created an F5.
An F5?
Don't worry. It'll be gone in 5, 4, 3, 2.
Stay here for a while and take it all in.
I got soul, and I'm super bad. Hey, take it to the fridge.